and resources, safety and nuclear waste management, without any doubts, are the main challenges for nuclear energy in this century. At current consumption of uranium equal to about 70,000 tons per year, existed low-cost uranium deposits will be finished through 50 years. The next important, very important issue is safety. It is postulated that the probability of accident must be 10 in minus 6 degree, or for current fleet of reactors, it's equal to one accident per 2,000 years. But really, unfortunately, such accidents are preceded significantly often about 1 per 10 or 20 years. If we consider Three Mile Island accident, Chernobyl, and Fukushima. One of solutions of this problem is, the only maybe solution of this problem is deployment of new types of reactors of the fourth generation with enhanced safety, consumed uranium-238 fast neutron reactors and thorium-232 as well in different types of reactors. And as you see, resources of thorium rather abundant. It's were estimated as 2.5 million of tons of thorium. But you can see in this table that here no data for China. But only today, Dr. B said that resources of thorium in China are estimated as 200,000 tons. So this time, and more detailed investigation, resources of thorium will be, of course, overestimated. And here you can see distribution of uranium deposits around the world, and uranium is isotope and monoelement forming ore deposits. Here distribution of thorium around the world, and here again data for China are absent, for example. And unlike uranium, thorium is monoisotope, monoisotope, but polyelement ores, and it practically always is accompanied by rare earth elements and niobium. And most of them are connected with alkaline magmatism, with crust of weathering and placers. And taking about new fourth generation reactors, most interesting for thorium-fueled reactors from my point of view are very high temperature gas reactor and fast molten salt reactor, maybe ADS system in future. And among existing types of reactors, most promising are sodium fast reactor and advanced heavy water reactor. Considering high level radioactive waste management, we should give special attention to the following issues: physical chemical properties of thorium, phase and chemical composition of fuel, reactor type and the spent nuclear fuel burn-up, phase and chemical composition of spent nuclear fuel, radionuclide content and heat of the SNF, and technology of the spent nuclear fuel reprocessing, because during this process we can add to components of spent nuclear fuel other elements from reprocessing media. As for uranium fuel cycle, two approaches exist: open cycle without reprocessing, and in this case matrix is the spent nuclear fuel itself, and closed nuclear fuel cycle with two types of technology: water extraction technology, SOREX, like Purex technology for uranium fuel cycle, and dry petrochemical technology for reprocessing of spent nuclear fuel in salt eutectic melt or by fluoride interaction. And also we can take into consideration waste from exploration of thorium ores. And based on our experience on waste from uranium fuel cycle, we can suggest such waste forms as boron silicate glaze for fission products, glass ceramics and ceramics for thorium and minor actinides, and metal alloy for technetium and platinum group metals. This is brief information about difference of tails from exploration of thorium and uranium deposits and radioactivity of tails from thorium deposits decrease very quickly because decay products of thorium has smaller half-life periods than decay products of uranium. And thorium is unique element because his official counterpart, uranium-233, in thermal neutron spectrum, fission with the larger number of neutrons. So possibility for operation of reactor in thermal reactor in breeding mode exists, and this suggestion was confirmed by USA specialist in shipping port light water reactor. But thorium fertile like uranium-238, so additional source of neutrons is required, and such additional source of neutrons are driving fuel composed of fissile materials, for example, uranium-233, uranium-235, or plutonium-239, and ADS device also. Thorium, like uranium-238, because both of them are fertile and transfer at neutron radiation into fissile counterpart uranium-233 and plutonium-239. But some difference between them exists, connected with different cross-section for capture of neutron. It's higher for thorium-232, so this element faster transfer to its counterpart. But protactinium-233 has significantly higher half-life period than neptunium-239. So to use all energetic potential of thorium, we can develop, we can try to reach very high burn-up of such fuel, higher than 100 of gigawatt per day per ton. For example, current light water reactor of uranium cycle has this value only as large as 40 gigawatt per day per ton of heavy metal. This picture shows processes of formation of uranium-233 from thorium-232, and also formation of very dangerous decay products of uranium-232 produced in this process also, such as wismut and thallium, which are very strong gamma emitters. This significantly complicate fabrication of thorium uranium-233 fuel, because uranium-232 always exists in mixture with uranium-233. But it's good for non-proliferation issue, because uranium-232, due to high gamma emission of its daughter product, is easily detected by current methods. And this you can see reaction caused formation of uranium-232 isotope from uranium-233. And it is known that the important advantage of thorium-uranium cycle is low content of plutonium and minor actinides, which are very dangerous and the most dangerous ecological elements in long period of time. So thorium fuel really contain spent fuel really contain lower amount of this element in comparison with conventional uranium-235, uranium-238 fuel cycle. This is another confirmation of this suggestion, showing that really content of minor actinides and in spent nuclear fuel is significantly low. That is very good from safety of ecological safety of thorium nuclear fuel cycle. But during irradiation in the thorium fuel, another minor actinide such as protactinium is formed, and one of its isotopes, such as protactinium-231, has rather large half-life period, about 30,000 of years, and its content in typical thorium spent nuclear fuel is about 50 to 70 grams per ton. It is three times higher than, for example, content of thorium in uranium spent nuclear fuel. So one of the problem of management of radioactive waste thorium nuclear fuel cycle, searching for methods for safe immobilization of protactinium-231. Also, content of very dangerous uranium-232 isotope reach about 0.3 weight percent in thorium fuel, compared with only 1 to 3 parts per billion in uranium-O2 spent nuclear fuel from light water reactor. And at content of uranium-232 higher than 10 ppm, the fabrication and all operation must be done in remote handling, so in distant mode. So it is significantly complicated and make more expensive this process. And it is not very surprising that thorium nuclear fuel has low content of plutonium and minor actinide, because you can see that thorium is located in left bottom corner of this diagram. This diagram is taken from Siaden monograph. But the situation is changed when we use different driving fuel. For example, if you use uranium-235 as driving fuel, the amount of minor actinides increase, and especially the content will be increased in the case of thorium-plutonium reactor-grade driving fuel, because this plutonium contains large content of heavy plutonium isotopes, such as plutonium-241 and plutonium-242. It is interesting to compare composition of decay fission products of two cycles, uranium fuel cycle and thorium fuel cycle. As you see, in thorium spent fuel, significantly higher content of selenium-79 isotope. It is also very long-lived isotope with half-life period about 1 million of years. And also higher, and selenium forms anionic species and easily migrate in underground water, because this anionic species does not soak onto mineral surface. And also fission products of thorium cycle contain more strontium 90. This is short-lived by heat generated isotope. But for technetium and iodine, two other long-lived fission products, contents rather similar. And this table confirms my conclusion about difference in fission product composition in thorium and nuclear fuel cycle. So radioactive waste formed both in thorium or uranium fuel cycle must be deposited in geological repository in special very, very durable form. And we have a lot of evidence from nature and from laboratory experiment and from calculations about high durability of such waste forms. And such confirmation are from stability of uranium and thorium ores, from research of radioactive minerals such as pyrochlore, monazite, and so on, geochemical data for rocks around natural fission reactor in Gambon, Western Africa, experiment on the waste forms solubility, radionuclide sorption, radiation behavior, and so on, and also theoretical calculation on performance assessment for high-level geological repository. And for example, here we know that some minerals with very high geological absolute age, about 2 billion of age, have closed isotopic system. It tells us that isotopic system were closed all time of existence of such minerals, and these minerals fix safely all initial and daughter decay products of such isotopic systems. Absolute age measured from different isotopic systems is equal for such minerals. Theoretical calculations also shows that most of the radionuclides are fixed very strong in the structure of the radioactive waste forms, and only some very long-lived fission products, such as technetium and selenium, can be released from radioactive waste forms and reach biosphere, but in very insignificant amounts. This is another suggestion of calculation doses from high-level waste repository for uranium fuel cycle. This is view of spent nuclear fuel based on uranium O2, and I guess that thorium O2 spent nuclear fuel will have the similar structure, because both uranium O2 and thorium O2 has the same fluoride, cubic fluoride type structure. So you can see here grains of uranium O2 and epsilon metal alloy phase composed of 5 elements, molybdenum, technetium, and 3 radionuclides of platinum group, ruthenium, rhodium, and palladium. And uranium spent nuclear fuel is not very good matrix itself, because due to heating at short-lived radionuclide decay, it will be heated and oxidized to uranium 308 with higher solubility. Also, in oxidizing environment, such fuel will actively interact with underground water, and uranium O2 will be replaced by minerals of uranium 6 or anion ion, such as scopite, for example, and will be actively dissoluted, and the radionuclide hosted in its structure will be released and can reach biosphere. Unlike uranium O2 spent nuclear fuel, thorium O2 spent nuclear fuel very stable in different environment, because thorium is monovalent element. It is not oxidized and always exist as torium for oxidation state. And solubility of thorium to very low, and experiment with real thorium spent nuclear fuel from light water breeder reactor shipping pot showed that solubility of such spent nuclear fuel composed of thorium uranium monoxide about 100 times lower than for spent nuclear fuel based on composed of uranium 2. West form special matrices are required for waste produced during reprocessing of spent nuclear fuel. What are the main goals of such reprocessing? To reuse fissile actinides, uranium-235 and plutonium-239, to facilitate high-level waste safe isolation, because if we separate high-level waste stream into fraction, long-lived nuclides, short-lived nuclides, it is easily for us safely manage with such fraction of isotope, suggesting different type of matrices for them. And to enlarge high-level waste repository capacity due to decrease of heat, because we can remove cesium-strontium fraction from high-level geological repository, and volume of waste suggested for disposal. So main fraction in uranium fuel sites are cesium-strontium, iodine, technetium, neptunium, metals of platinum group, and also lanthanide, actinide fraction. The same processes named thorix is suggested for reprocessing of spent thorium O2-based fuel. And if purex method is very mature technology, up to now more than 150,000 tons of such spent fuel, commercial fuel and weapon from weapon reactors were reprocessed. For thorium, we have no great experience in such technology. And I said you that because thorium O2 is significantly more stable than uranium O2, we need add some components such as hydrofluorine and nitrate of aluminum to exit to facilitate solubility of thorium O2-based nuclear fuel. This scheme of thorix process is given for advanced high water spent nuclear fuel reactor. So after this processes, we will receive liquid high-level waste as in uranium fuel cycle, and depending on final product, we will receive different types of waste, and we should select different types of matrices for immobilization. This is special, this composition of actinide rare earth fraction, and we have a lot of data on research of such matrices for uranium fuel cycle. I show you very quickly our result on radiation behavior, on corrosion behavior, and so on. Very small experience exists on perochemical reprocessing of thorium-based spent nuclear fuel. This is special matrices for this reactor. So common experience, current experience of operation thorium-fueled reactors exceed 200 reactors years. And main types of reactors are high-temperature gas reactor and advanced and heavy water reactor, and one of them is also molten salt breeder reactor, but it was work not on thorium, but uranium-233 fuel. So some suggestion exists about most promising types of reactor for the future application. From my point of view, it is very interesting, very high temperature reactor, no metal inactive zone, so very high burn up of nuclear fuel, and it can reach practically 18% of heavy metal. This is brief information about existed gas, high temperature gas reactor. The main problem, high cost for fuel fabrication. But since the 60s, it was reduced more than 20,000 times to about $7,000 per kilogram. That is rather similar with conventional uranium plutonium MOX fuel. One block with mass about 80 kilograms contained 4 kilograms of uranium and thorium and 13 millions of trace particles. This is why the price of this fuel very high, because it consists of very small trace particles with kernel of uranium and thorium in central part. This is again data for small amount of minor actinides and plutonium in this thorium high temperature gas reactor. And this reactor is very promising because it allow use not only electricity, but have wide application in other different industry. For example, hydrogenium production, organic synthesis, and so on. This is another type of promising reactor, molten salt reactor. Safe for this reactor is typical of high safety and very simple management of high level waste. And we suggest ceramic for lanthanide fraction and iron alloy for metal fraction of this reactor. So my conclusions. In open thorium cycle, waste is spent nuclear fuel itself. It is appropriate for light water reactor and very high temperature to gas reactor with very high burn up. And for closed cycle, this spent nuclear fuel reprocessing by water extraction or dry technology, we can suggest the same matrices as we developed for uranium cycle. Glass, glass ceramics for fission product ceramics, for long-lived actinides, alloys for technetium. This is some references used in my presentation.
Thank you for that.
A question about Torex. You know that Purex is a big mess. It's an aqueous process to extract plutonium and separate it from the rest of the waste. So why do you want to develop something which is as messy as Purex when you could do something much simpler using pyro reprocessing where all the actinides go to the same electrode? You don't need to separate things, provided you go to fast neutron systems. I mean, it's another reason to go to fast neutrons is that reprocessing is much, much simpler. And you know, these aqueous processes are a big mess. You produce a lot of pollution impact on the environment in addition to, you know, the problem you have with radioactivity. So why not go to something simpler?
Sorex, this is the same that Purex.
Yeah, that's the problem. That's the issue.
So it's based on TBF, tributyl phosphate extragent. But some fuel with very high burn up cannot be reprocessed by Sorex processes because radiation destruction of extragent. So in this case, if we need reprocess fuel to extract fission components, we must use pyrochemical technologies such as molten salt technology in F-tactic of kalium chloride, lithium chloride, or fluoride gas technology. So I don't see here any problem. This water extraction technology is very mature technology, pyrochemical technology, not very good investigated, but we will use experience from uranium fuel cycle for thorium nuclear fuel cycle in any case.